I'm Fleur, I'm 29. I'm a mature age student at UniSA studying psychological science and with a sub-major of Aboriginal studies. Decided that I wanted to go to uni. It took me a while to figure out what I wanted to do. So I ended up finding psychology, being able to learn about how people work, why they work, and what kind of things causes them to be the way they are. And so enrolled, and of course being Indigenous, wanting to learn more about my history, I enrolled with a sub-major of Indigenous Aboriginal studies as well. It was just their open day that kind of grabbed me. I went to all of the uni open days. They just seemed so approachable. They were really friendly. Their courses and their run, and the fact that they run a specific Indigenous course for first years was really eye-catching for me, really. I enrolled and the campus looked really, really nice. So that kind of made my decision for me. Learning about people's stories, where they came from and things like that really interested me, and just trying to help them out in whatever, I suppose, crisis or issue that they had was really something I was keen to do. I wanted something a bit more full-time and a career that I could go the long-term with, not just something that would be last me 5 or 6 years. So I decided to do that, and the fact that I loved working with kids and just the outlook of wanting to help them really was something that I wanted to get into. So I thought psychology would be a good start. When I started uni, I put down that I was an Indigenous student, and so I was linked up with the Indigenous Student Services out at UniSA at McGill, and they would send me emails on a regular basis about events and things like that. So they sent out an expression of interest about the position, and it sounded really, really good, the fact that they were encouraging students to be able to work while they study and to have a job when they finished. I found it very much like a job interview, I suppose a bit more relaxed. So the process, I had to put in my resume and a cover letter expressing my interest into the cadetship, and then I had a couple of meetings with management around, you know, what I want out of life, what my goals are, and what I'm, I suppose, hoping to achieve if once I finish uni, and so that went really well. It was really relaxed, and they just made me feel really comfortable, and then got the call up to say that I'd been successful. So it was a good process. Doing the SYC professional learning that we've got, so that's been really, really interesting and very I suppose beneficial for my learning, not just so much with work, but also taking that back to uni and being able to relay that kind of that outlook, that work outlook to uni as well, not just for more of the theoretical learnings. So within Trace of Place, it's primarily the emergency accommodation options. So we provide, that's our main thing that we work with our young people, but we do provide that service that, you know, if they've got mental health issues or schooling issues or they're interested in getting into a job, that we can help them out in that way as well. And we also help our young people once they've moved from emergency accommodation into independent living, you know, helping them apply for that funding to be able to get furniture, because, you know, if you've been couch surfing for a year, or you pretty much just have the clothes on your back and maybe a few other bags. I would say do it. I think the main reasons to be able to do it is that you are going to get that support from the uni. They're very encouraging of our Indigenous students to be able to work in human services field, because it is lacking a lot, and that you get the support from SYC. There are always people there to support you along the way, even if you don't think that you need that support, but they just come and check on you to say, you know, how are you going? You get those kind of things. And the main one is that, yeah, you get a job at the end of your study. So you have a full-time position sitting there waiting for you, knowing that you know you are helping young people and that it is a great organisation to be able to work for. I suppose this position means to me in this cadetship is that it's allowing me to get that hands-on experience. It's allowing me to be able to do what I love to do, and is work with those young people that are challenging and that do fall below the radar and are kind of are forgotten about, that know that I suppose they've got that support. You know, I know growing up through my life, I had that support, I had that loving family, but not all young people, I suppose, do have that loving family. And there's a number of reasons why that could be. And so just being, I suppose, that person that's standing there, that's not going anywhere and is willing, I suppose, to fight for those young people, to be able to help them achieve, really, and to help them to be successful in life. I'm excited about this initiative because it has opened up a lot of pathways available to me.